Good morning. Welcome to the Heart and Soul programs of India Bridge to Life Family Counseling Ministry. So, Lord is so gracious to each one of us. I'm sure this month God has blessed us with good rains and good situations. And our children are going to school this academic year with a great hope. I think in the vast growth of education realm, people are all focusing for reaching 100%. There are 2-3 verses are guiding this world now. That means American performance and Swiss accuracy and Japan speed. People like to drive more powerful vehicle. They want to reach places in more easily, more comfortable way, very quickly. They are ready to invest money. Once upon a time, we pay only 1,000, 10,000 rupees for a bike. Now the bike rate also is very high. It is to 25 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 6 lakhs. Harley Davidson is more than 6 lakhs. Even an average family member, family also is buying these kinds of vehicles. By means the understanding is they want to reach fast. So they want more powerful vehicles. So our quality concern is changing by day to day. Is it a need? Definitely. Definitely. As the human life becomes so speedy now, therefore we are unable to fulfill the needs within these 24 hours. The Prime Minister of India also having the 24 hours, and every human being in the world is having only 24 hours. Time is fixed for anybody irrespective of their positions. Time and ages is fixed. We do not know when you are going to see our last end of life. That is not a big thing. But before that, we want to live powerfully. Live powerfully. Jesus alone say, I come that you might have life and might have it more abundantly. Lord expected everybody should live abundant life. That doesn't mean it is full of money, full of riches. That is not that understanding. Even the poor families with very low income is living with the Lord of abundance. The full of joy, full of power, full of glory is there. They worship God, real God, and They shared the love each other. They live with a bowl of rice. That is enough for them. But at the same time, the richest people in the world are wasting money, spending lavishly. They don't find any meaning. They don't find any value. Not respecting. They're looting bank, taking the country's money to abroad. They're cheating general public and enjoying money, spending money for women's pleasures. Many, many notorious things are happening like that. John Rockefeller had the same experience till the age of 43. And he became a businessman. Rockefeller was a very big businessman. He could not count the money he is earning daily. That much money accumulated in his wealth. He spent money lavishly and tried to enjoy the life. But ultimately he realized that there is no enjoyment for him. Even if he drinks, even if he is dealing with the people, no more enjoyment. Then there he learned something is missing from his life. Then humble himself. He read the word of God. The Lord touched his heart. And he started a foundation. At the age of 43, he was kept away from all kind of worries. Because he feared death. So he knows, how can I enjoy all this wealth within my time? So if the death comes any moment, I will die. But that moment, when the realization comes, the real lights brightened in his life. He got this enlightenment from the world. Love your people. Care your people. So during this time he read the 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love is everything in the world. Not the lust, not the eros, not the selfish love. Self-love, love in this. The New Testament promotes the love and its offerings. Do the good things in people in season and out of season. So Rockefeller started at the age of 43. He read the 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. Then he was ready to spend money for many kinds of inventions. Because of his spending nature, he invested for education alone, including penicillin was discovered with his money. His money became so creative. His money became an encouragement for many areas. So Rockefeller died. John Rockefeller died at the age of 98. He was a man with a lot of satisfaction. So why does this make? Because of his behavior. He made a behavior patterns. So we were talking about last few classes about how do we develop a strong desire, strong behavior. In the light of the book of Daniel, we realize that whatever the situation people may face, that has lesser influence on people's life. But only those who are having a stern decision in their life. Daniel experienced God very well in his life. Daniel was ready to accept challenges. He was a man of decision. He was a man of wisdom. He was a man of relationship. He was a man of confidence. How did he develop all such behavior patterns? Because of his fellowship with God, because of his fellowship with his own people. Even Chaldeans, Nebuchadnezzar, made such a conscious effort to change his persons. By putting them new names, by giving them new situations, instructing them to speak the Chaldean languages. None of this work never put big changes in Daniel. Because Daniel's insight and his friend's insight was very much strong. That focused on God, the living God. They know us better than anybody else. No more advice is essential for them because they were strong in their Lord. Again, it talks about these four men. God given them the knowledge and the skill in all literature and in wisdom. Daniel had understanding in all visions and in all dreams. God has given them the skills. How do we get the skills? Last time we discussed about the lack of skills may to make people failure to show their established character. That's what Romans chapter 7 verses 14 to 24 says. I wanted to do the good things, but I could not do. I could not show my real, genuine desire through my character. Why? I was failed. The Saint Paul says this. It is true in many peoples. I wanted to do the good things, but I could not do it. There I have learned. There's a rule is controlling me. There's a law of sin is controlling me. That makes me to do the unwanted things. That makes me to do the undesirable behavioral patterns. That is what the Word of God says. Word of God is very strict in this way. You have to say stop. Because if people show the bad behavioral pattern, that's the best place for Satan to occupy your heart. In Acts chapter 5, we can see a family. Ananias, meaning is a beautiful man. His wife's name is Sapphira, meaning is a beautiful woman. In the first century church, the God Spirit was working. The Acts chapter 5, it says very clearly, the first few verses, 1 to 6, I say, it says, they all put all the money together. That was the beginning of socialism. That was the beginning of fraternity and equality. The first century church was a real model to the world. Nobody claimed that I have contributed much. The people contributed maximum. They sold their property and put it in the common treasury. The church distributed to them equally, not by considering their positions or nothing. So I have noticed that in some organizations, they are also doing the same thing sometimes. Some churches are also practicing. So some priests are getting very meager amount to leave. Maybe 2,000-3,000 rupees. Some college principal, they are getting very huge salary, but they contributed to the missions to help the poor, to establish colleges and schools. The principal is getting hardly 3,000-5,000 rupees to buy his soap cheap and giving for some money for food. So I am excited to see many priests, they are doing the same thing now. I appreciate their commitment. So Peter stood before them. Ananias brought the money which he sold the property. Holy Spirit of God started to speak through Peter. Peter told him. Peter asked him, is that money you brought to this church? Yes, exactly. This is the money which I got it from selling my property. The Peter sold. Why did you permit the Satan to withhold your mind? The land is belong to you. Before selling and after selling, the money is belong to you. Why did you say this lies to the Holy Spirit? So we are never expecting such a lower standard from your side. Because this is God's church where you cannot say lies. You must bring the real money. It is God's presence is here. So now I am telling, many people are afraid to come before God because of this reason. They want to find out their own protective way. Why? The first century church is asking all money. Then, if any emergency will come, who will spend money? So they were thinking of the human way. They were thinking, we can keep this money, collect this money, and protect some layers for us, keep something for us. But God doesn't like it. As we are in God's kingdom, why should we be worried? Jesus said, why should you worry? Your God knows. Even one hair is falling from your hair. Your God knows. Why don't you make such kind of a character to trust God for anything else? God is sufficient for you. God is meeting your all kinds of needs. I have no doubt about it. And there are hundreds of experiences I can say from my own experience. If you are real in your God's sight, God is a real God in your life. So Matthew chapter 8, 36 says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, then all things will be added to you. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all things will be added to you. So what I am trying to say, develop a behavioral pattern, a Christian behavior. Christian behavior include many elements there. This is not a simple thing. You have to exhibit the fullness of Christ into your face, into your life. There we can see the love. There we can see the selfless love. God's love, agape's love. The Christian behavior include agape love, unconditional love. There is no doubt about it. In Christian behavior contains the fullness of the faith. You have to put your all faith in Lord. And you are listening from the Lord. Your sources of energy is Lord. Your sources of knowledge is God. Your sources of protection is God. Fully God-oriented. That is another element of Christian behavioralism. First, I talked to you about the love. In Genesis chapter 22, we can see. In 26 also, we can see the great faith of Abraham. Before exercising his faith, he put his whole love upon God. God is more important to me than my son Isaac. He was ready to sacrifice Isaac for God. God wanted that only. Yes, Isaac. Yes, Abraham. You loved me more than your son. Exemplary faith can create such a heavenly situation. Through him, God blessed generations and generations in this world. God wanted to see such kind of love. Then that become the part of Christian behavior. Simply a person says that I am born and brought up in a Christian family. You cannot become a Christian that way. Unless and until you carry the real Christ in you. And your faith also. Such a boundless faith. There is no boundary for you. You have to show your faith. Even this man, Daniel, he knows his God is with him. But he has to face tests one by one. He has to overcome the situations. He has to overcome the trials. He has to overcome the tests. He has to overcome the trials. He was ready. He never prayed to the Lord, Lord, save me from, exempt me from these kinds of tests. I am a child. We are only four in this cruel king's country. So please leave me alone. Elohi, Elohi, lemma sharatan. He never prayed like that. He said, I am confident to face my challenges because an exemplary faith has created such a great confidence in this man. So this is a pattern. This is a Christian behavior pattern for us. We need to face it. We need to accept it. Then only we can say that I am having such a higher standard in my life. Christianity is not at all a religion. Christianity is not at all a sect. It is not a communal group. It is a universal understanding. When you follow the way of Christ, you become a real Christian, not by your small understanding, but through your total commitment. Your character plays a vital role you to show that you are a perfect person as a Christian. Even how much I can say, how much you can say, depend on your call, depend on your integrity. So these are the two vital elements you should not forget about it. So for saying that, you need a skill development. For example, we can see, consider the children who failed in their examinations, especially mathematical examinations. What is happening to their mathematical examination? The first child may do so because she lacks necessary skills, and despite trying to complete the examination because of lack of skills. She had never practiced in such a way. So goal is to find out some skill remedial teachings for them. I know one of my friend's son was very poor in learning and calculating in mathematics. In Indian situation, the teachers were teaching in that way. Old mental work. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. 1 into 1. So the logic will work. How does it happen? Many signals. Then they were much afraid of this young boy, 9 years old. But God provided a chance for them to work in Ireland. They shared me this story. In that system, what they did is, they sent this boy with their school mates to a supermarket to buy items with their money. They bought chocolates. Then I asked them, how much chocolate you bought it for your money? Then their logic works. And how much you are going to give to others? Distribute this sweets to all people. How much it is? How much was the original you purchased? How much you give to 12 people? Like that. They have given them some life skills. The child learned the mathematics. Now he is a topper in his studies. So this is the way God wants us to experience the Christianity, the faith. And another area is to, sometimes that child is able to calculate when she is getting the reward. Reward is motivating her to think about it. But in school situation and exam situation, she is failed. Why? Because maybe it is something happened in the family communications. How does her mind is working only in the reward situations and not acting, not responding in less rewarding situations? For that, what we need a parental training. We need a family therapy. So people could understand, the child could understand how to relate with the situational. And another area is, this child, the third child is calculating things, but sometimes she cannot do it. Then what happened is, we have to see that is a need to reduction of the stress or anxiety factor. In front of the group, in front of the a bad situation, some people's brain is not at all responding. They'll be upset. So all such things are creating a kind of patterns. Some people are afraid to speak to public speaking. Some people are afraid to climb in the steps. Sometimes they have developed a phobia to relate with some, to deal with certain situations. But our God is good to help us. We need to learn how to remove the anxiety. We need to learn how to communicate a real fact in home situations. How to deal in a political situations, in a country situations. We cannot match with the growth of India with the match with the growth of USA sometimes. The situation in USA is different. The situation in India is different. We cannot match and say that we are great. It's not a right attitude to say we are great, better than other people. We are better in some areas, they are also better in some areas. Don't match with a person with another person. You may have 6 feet height, I may have only 5.5 feet height. How can I compare my height with your height? It's God's plan. So with many misunderstandings, we are putting unwanted elements into our arguments that will influence people and their behavior patterns. It's not sound good. Here, Daniel never compared. You put the testers with us. Let them eat their food. Let them eat our food. He never said, we are far better than our people. They never glorified themselves. The word of God is saying like that. The king interviewed Daniel and friends. And the king realized that, and among them all, none was found like Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Therefore, they served before king. King appointed him in the right place because he was satisfied with their performance. Your performance. I told you about the American performance or Indian performance. Whatever the performance depend on the ability you prove through your character. May God bless you with this verse. So rest we will talk the next week. Until that, God say, God may reach you, God may fill you with His wisdom. Thank you so much for listening to today's Heart and Soul program. May God bless you. Thank you. All I know is I'm not